Jared here with CarBuzz.com, and today I am bringing you a review of the 2019 Toyota Tacoma. Now, we are living in a crossover-obsessed world, but if you check out the sales charts, pickup trucks are still dominating. You've got the Ford F-150 sitting on a pedestal as the sales king, then you've got the Chevy Silverado, and then you've got the Ram 1500, although those two are about to do a little swappity-doo because the new Ram is so good. But if you check out what car sits in fourth place, that is this guy right here, the Toyota Tacoma. Why is this thing such a sales success? That's what we are going to find out today. We are driving the 2019 TRD Sport model, which, as you can tell by this amazing color and by the graphics on the back and the cool front end design, the TRD Sport is the most on-road oriented. You've also got the TRD Off-Road and TRD Pro models. So this one does have four-wheel drive, but as you can tell by the tires, it is more street oriented. So let's go ahead and get it on the road to see how it drives. All right, so behind the wheel of the Tacoma, this is pretty much like a trip back in time for me, back to the 1990s, that is, because this truck just, the drivetrain is just really weird, and I'll tell you a little bit more about it. There's a 2.7 liter four-cylinder engine with 159 horsepower. I'm not testing that. I don't recommend you get that. That just sounds like a really weak amount of horsepower. This is the optional engine, the 3.5 liter V6 with 278 horsepower and 265 foot-pounds of torque. Most of the upper trim levels of Tacoma are already going to have that engine. Two transmission options. You've got either a 6-speed manual. Unfortunately, we do not have that. I'd really like to test that, but it wasn't available to test this week. So I've got the 6-speed automatic, and the engine is fine. It just doesn't really talk well with this automatic transmission. So here's what I mean with that. I need a burst of power, downshift. Come on, downshift again. Come on. All right, there we go. It has power. The engine has grunt. The problem is it's just very hard to access it with this 6-speed automatic. It feels very much like my 2002 Pathfinder, which was the first car I ever owned, which only had a 4-speed automatic, but it had power. You just had to like wait for it and then it would deliver. Now, there is a faux manual mode that you can stick the transmission into. It's S. Like most of Toyota's automatic transmissions, it only holds whatever gear you have it set to. So if you have it set to fourth, it will shift all the way up to that. It's not like a true manual mode. There aren't paddle shifters or anything else like that. You do have this button called ECT power, and that'll hold the gears a little bit longer. I tried that out. It does work a little bit, but I don't find that power is all that easy to access on this car. And the ride is, as you can just see, we went over a speed bump, very trucky. Not a very comfortable ride. So if you're looking to buy this as a truck that is kind of going to replace your family vehicle, that's something that a lot of people want their pickup trucks to do, is replace their SUV or whatever with something a little bit more rugged and practical. This is definitely going to be a lot stiffer than whatever SUV you have on your driveway. You can get either the access cab or the double cab. We have the double cab with the sorry about that. The ride's really stiff. The 5-foot bed, you can also get a 6-foot bed. You know, if you need the extra space, go for the 6-foot, but this barely fits in my driveway as it is. I can't believe that mid-size trucks have gotten this big, but they, most of them are not as comfortable as their full-size equivalents. I've driven a lot of the full-size trucks, the Tundra, the Silverado, the F-150, and the Ram, and I find all of them to be more comfortable than almost any of these trucks in the mid-size segment. And that being said, all of the big ones are available with V8 engines, whereas this V6 isn't that good in terms of fuel economy. It's all right. Gets 19 mpg in the city, 22 on the highway, and 20 combined with the automatic as we have it configured. It's really been rather hard to tell what I'm getting in terms of fuel economy because it only measures from the last time I filled up. You can go into the computer and get like more intricate data, but it's a little bit confusing and hard to parse out. So this tank, for example, I've only been getting 17.7 miles per gallon. I drove this all the way down to Miami and I averaged about 21 to 23, depending on how the traffic was going. But it was not comfortable on the way down. Me and my videographer, we drove all the way from Orlando to Miami, about a 4-hour drive. And by the time we got to Miami, our butts were very, very sore. We've got these optional leather seats and they're just very stiff, very like thick leather. Probably really good if you're going to get it all muddy and dirty and you just want to hose it off really easily, but not great for sitting in the truck for 4 hours. A lot of my fellow colleagues have complained that the driving position in the Tacoma is not great because a lot of them are taller than me. I am but a wee lad. I'm only about 5'9" on a good day. So the seating position feels fine for me, not excellent. There's not a whole lot of adjustability with the steering wheel here. And unlike a lot of other trucks, the floor feels really high here. So you don't really get to sit like you're upright in a chair like at your house. You sit with your legs facing forward more like a car. So definitely try the Tacoma before you buy. I think a lot of taller people might have a problem with it. But my videographer, who also drove the truck, he's 6'3", and he really wasn't complaining too much about the driving position either. As far as how the truck drives, it just drives like a truck, people. This is not like a sporty car, even though it says TRD Sport on the tailgate back there. The steering is absolutely lackadaisical, just no feedback to it whatsoever. There's tons of slack in it. You just kind of point it in vaguely the direction that you want it to go, and it kind of goes there. So in terms of like sporty driving dynamics, like obviously this is not the kind of truck you're looking at. Interestingly, I think my colleagues have mentioned that the TRD Pro, which is like the most off-road crazy, sort of like a Raptor-ish competitor that Toyota offers, is the most comfortable, even though it's the most off-road capable, because the Fox racing shocks are just so capable that they actually make it more comfortable on the road. I'll have to test one of those to confirm, but you definitely want to try out a couple of Tacoma trim levels before you end up buying it. Towing capacity is okay for the segment, not great. This particular one that we're riding in tows up to 6,400 pounds and has a 1,620 pound payload capacity, which is not as good as the new Ford Ranger or either of the General Motors twins, the Chevy Colorado or the GMC Canyon, but it is better than the very aging Nissan Frontier and the Honda Ridge line. This truck also has a couple of safety features that are pretty darn good. Toyota has gotten just so great with this on a lot of their cars. It has standard Toyota Safety Sense technology that's going to get you things like the lane departure warning, which is a bit annoying on a big truck like this because you're going to find yourself out of the lane very frequently and it beeps at you quite a lot. You do get adaptive cruise control, which is awesome. I'm super happy to have that here, but come on, Toyota, it doesn't bring you to a stop. So what the heck's the point of having it? We also have an option on here. We have like a premium tech package that's going to give us like park assist, which is pretty helpful. So you don't hit that bed into anything and ruin it. You also have the blind spot monitoring and rear cross traffic alert. That's going to help you as well. But the Tacoma is definitely not, not great on the street. It's a little bit rough. And I think if you're going to drive this every day to replace your regular vehicle, you're probably better off with a bigger, larger, more comfortable Toyota Tundra or one of its competitors. And now we're going to go ahead and pull over and really get a blast from the past, because this Toyota interior just really reminds me of how far we've come in terms of interior cabin technology. Here we are in the Tacoma's interior, and I thought it would be fun to review this car as if it was 2008. So if it was 2008, I would be going, oh my goodness, I'm so impressed. This pickup truck has so much stuff in it. It has a touchscreen stereo. It has a wireless charger. I don't know how my phone is going to charge without being plugged in. That seems super strange in 2008. Dual zone automatic climate control, heated seats. Man, this thing's basically a luxury truck. But in 2019, these things are just kind of, you expect them to be here. The cabin is kind of weirdly laid out. You've got like these very simple gauges. You have like a little helper screen in the middle and the nicer Toyota Tacoma trims. Not anything super special to say there. The steering wheel feels like a nice leather. I do like the way the steering wheel feels, although the steering itself is a little bit weird. And the driving position is not perfect, as I mentioned. It kind of feels like the buttons just like weren't meant to be there. Like they're in weird spots for like the Bluetooth and the radar cruise control. Like you can tell that there was nothing there before and Toyota just kind of carved out spaces for them. You've got this pretty basic radio system here. It says apps on it. Don't get like super excited for that. It's just stuff like navigation and audio. Although for the 2020 model year, the Tacoma, Sequoia, 4Runner, and Tundra will all be the first Toyota models to finally get Android Auto. Hallelujah. So if you want to wait for 2020 for that, go ahead. Home gets you Toyota's basic audio, your weather, and the map. 3 display screen. I kind of like that. Climate controls, they're pretty basic. Dual zone automatic climate controls, although the screen that displays the information is kind of small and it's kind of like really low down here. All the buttons are kind of weird. You've got like your defrosters here. You've got push button start, which is huge. I didn't know that Toyota did that on a Tacoma. Here's where you've got your four wheel drive controls. You can flip it into four wheel high. If you want to put it into four wheel low, you've got instructions for that depending on your transmission up here. So I'm going to go half the head and put it into neutral, push down, and now I can get it into four-wheel low. I also have a limited slip differential out back. So although this is the TRD Sport, you can actually do some off-roading in it. And storage space is pretty good. You've got your Qi wireless charger, which you can turn on or off to charge your phone. You've got a USB port with two more in the center console. You've got your normal 12-volt. You've got your little control for the sliding rear window, which is really nice as well. This is that extra power button that I was talking about. Two cup holders here and another one here, so you have plenty of room for all of your drinks. So in terms of practicality, it's just kind of okay, like junky materials. You're not going to feel like super luxurious in here, nor are you going to feel super comfortable in the back seat. So let's go check that out. All right, so back here, I've got a few interesting things to talk about. You do have some seat folding here and some extra storage. So if you lift up the seat bottoms, you do have some storage underneath here that sort of locks into place. That's pretty useful as well if you don't want to store stuff in the bed. And then you just kind of pull this tab and this seat will fall flat. You do have some extra storage behind there that you can close on, although notice you do have to take the headrests off in order to do that. Once you sit down back here, you have to climb up. Not a whole lot of space, not a whole lot of head space either. This is definitely on the lower end of comfortability for pickup trucks. So if you have adults that you want to put back here, they're not going to be hugely comfortable back here. You only have two basic cup holders and no rear air or any other amenities like that. Now let's go ahead and check out the bed. So now as I hop out, and I really do have to do a little hop because this truck doesn't have running boards, walk past this little TRD Sport sticker. I think it looks very cool, very 80s, very retro. You might disagree with me. We've got the 5-foot bed. You can also get an optional 6-footer. Although when I was playing around with the configurator, when you put the 6-foot bed option on this, you couldn't get this awesome blue. And if it meant sacrificing this color, I would not get the 6-foot bed. So the tailgate is damped, so it does fall pretty quietly down. And then we do have a tonneau cover on here as well. Very easy to use. You've just got clips over here on this side, tri-folding style. So you just kind of clip it up. It goes all the way here. You've got little clips here to clip it into place. And now you can just kind of sit and enjoy yourself. This one that Toyota sent me doesn't have any sort of bed step, so there's not going to be an easy way to get up in here, but it isn't like super tall, so it's not so hard to get into. So now let's go ahead and price out our 2019 Toyota Tacoma TRD Sport. Okay, so it's time to price out our 2019 Toyota Tacoma. You've got a pretty big spread in terms of options. You can get an access cab or a double cab with a 5 or a 6 foot bed, but I'm just going to be talking about the cheapest that each trim level starts off at. So you've got the SR trim, which starts out at $25,850. You're going to get standard Toyota safety sense, a rear view camera, a deck rail system in the bed, skid plates, and plenty of USB ports. Stepping up to the SR5 trim for $27,625 gets you the Toyota Entune infotainment, the multi-information display in the gauge cluster, fog lights, and a tire pressure monitoring system. So now we get on to the TRD Sport trim, which is what we've tested here today. This starts at $32,545. This is the trim that I definitely recommend at least starting off at because it's where the Tacoma starts to look like a really good truck. You get 17-inch alloy wheels, wireless phone charger, you get the smart push-button key start, and an auto limited slip differential. I think this is the best looking package, and it's where I'd at least start to look at the Tacoma. Then you've got the TRD Off-Road, which is a little bit more expensive, $33,800, a little more rugged than the TRD Sport. If you're doing a lot of off-road driving, or if you just like a more off-road looking truck, this is the one you're going to want. You get the power rear window, crawl control, multi-terrain select, a locking rear differential, Bilstein shock absorbers, and knobbier tires. Then you've got the limited trim, which I can't not recommend enough. I've never driven it, but it's $37,490, and it's like the luxury version of this truck, and this truck really just doesn't provide a lot of luxury anyway, so I don't know why you'd get it, but if you do, it does come with a lot of standard features, including the blind spot monitoring, rear parking sensors, moonroof, and 18-inch alloy wheels, which are optional on the truck we have here, which is why I wouldn't really look at the limited trim. The one that I think is going to be your best bet is the Toyota Tacoma TRD Pro trim, which starts at $42,660. These are the ones that dealers are charging markups for right now because they are so cool and so popular. You're going to get a trim specific grille, automatic climate control, the TRD Pro badging, Fox racing shocks, and a high performance exhaust. You can even get like a sort of snorkel looking thing on it. It's a very cool looking truck, and it's the one that everybody is paying up for right now. Our tester as optioned is $42,430, which is almost as much as that TRD Pro. So you're really not even spending that much more to just get the cooler TRD Pro truck. That's because we have the TRD Premium Sport Package for $28,90. Which gets us the automatic climate control, leather heated seats, JBL with navigation, auto headlights, and a moonroof. I kind of like that package, but it doesn't really make this truck all that much more livable. I think cloth seats are just probably better. I would miss the JBL audio, though. That sounds pretty good. And also having built-in nav is pretty good. But as I mentioned, you're going to get Android Auto and Apple CarPlay starting next year. Then there's the tech package. I think that's a bargain for $770. That gets you the parking assist, blind spot monitoring, and the rear cross traffic alert. For that price, I will totally take that. But in my humble opinion, I think you should just get the TRD Pro. It's going to hold its value even better than the already stunningly resale value on a regular Tacoma. All right, so how do we sum up our time with the 2019 Tacoma? I have a couple of problems with this truck, but it's more of a problem that I have with the entire midsize truck category. They've just gotten so big now that I think you're better off spending a little bit more money to just get a full size with a big, nice, lazy V8, a little bit more ride, a lot more storage. I think the midsize trucks are just not the best value right now. So where does the Tacoma stack up? Sort of in the middle. You've got the Jeep Gladiator, which is way more flashy and cool. You can take off the roof, take off the doors. That's pretty darn cool. You've got the Ford Ranger, which has a much more modern powertrain. And then you've got the Honda Ridgeline, which I think is the dark horse in this segment because it is the most livable on the road. The Tacoma is just shy of being comfortable. I think Toyota really just needs to tune that suspension a little bit better, reorganize the cabin a little bit. I think the addition of Android Auto and Apple CarPlay are really going to make it feel a lot more modern next year for the 2020 model year. But I still see why the Tacoma sells so well. I think the Gladiator is going to take a lot of the shine away from the Tacoma, but this is still one of the better looking trucks in this this segment, especially with this gorgeous blue in the TRD sport trim, which is why I'm gonna give this 2019 Tacoma a worth a look. And if you wanna see the best deals on the Toyota Tacoma, be sure to click the link in the description below and subscribe to the CarBuzz YouTube channel to see more videos just like this one and download our apps on iOS and Android. That's where you can keep up with all of the latest and greatest in automotive news and to see more reviews just like this one. Hope you've enjoyed the video. See you next time.